China's continued aggression shows a complete disregard of international law. That's according to Senator Francis Tolentino. He says while China is not required to respond to note verbals, it should at least admit the incursion being done by its Coast Guard in Philippine waters.
They have ignored it, and their manner of incremental and continuous ignoring of our protests would just show that this is a trend, this is a pattern, so to speak. But what the government has been doing, and even the previous administration has done, is correct. Even if they don't reply, it keeps on piling up, and later on it can be used against China by the international community, by our government as well, to justify that the violations being done even after the issuance of that arbitral ruling are continuing.
For now, Tolentino says government can look at other ways to assert the country's territorial rights in areas being claimed by China.
You can beef up our resources within Calayan Islands. More classrooms, more livelihood programs in the area. It would really show that it is ours. The area is sustainable. You don't need a supply from other areas
very
to support
good.
Life. There mm-hmm. should be economic activity. There are people living there.
The U.S. backing the Philippines in the face of China's increasing aggression in the West Philippine Sea. Washington calls on Beijing to respect the international law of the sea amid the escalating swarming of Chinese vessels in Philippine waters. The U.S. says China's presence not only affects the livelihood of local fishing communities, but also reflects its disregard for other claimants. The U.S. also raising concerns over the Chinese Coast Guard's seizure of a rocket debris from Philippine naval forces last month. The Philippines filed a diplomatic protest over that encounter. Washington's statement also follows another report saying China's Coast Guard challenged a Philippine vessel carrying supplies to troops in Ayungin Shoal. The Western Command personnel of the military were shadowed by Chinese vessels and were even warned not to push through with their resupply mission. But the Filipinos stood their ground.
There's no need for us to seek your permission to do such a thing. We are firm in our resolve that that part belongs to us, and that we will never give in to any foreign forces or that will try to take it away from us.
As for President Marcos, he vows to preserve the country's security and stability following the recent encounters with China.
The security and stability of the country remains the priority. I laud the armed forces for sustaining your existing defense and security engagements whilst exploring new areas for cooperation with your counterparts overseas.
Five police officers sacked over their alleged involvement in the kidnapping of an online cockfighting executive in Laguna. Philippine National Police Chief Rodolfo Azrin Jr. signed the dismissal orders after the PNP's Internal Affairs Service found substantial evidence against them.
Definitely, hindi na po ito makakabalik sa serbisyo, Sir Mar, dahil nga napakahigpit po ng panuntunan na mabigat po ang sinampang kaso sa kanila, grave misconduct, kahit ano pong leverage ang gamitin nila para po ibalik sila sa serbisyo, I doubt po makakabalik pa po sila sa serbisyo po sa bigat po ng kaso na kanilang kinakaharap po.
Three of those who were relieved have also been indicted by the Justice Department prosecutors for robbery and abduction. They're accused of pretending to be National Bureau of Investigation agents who stormed the house of Ricardo Lasco in August of 2021 on the pretense of arresting him for alleged large-scale estafa.